Pierre-Auguste Renoir was a French artist. He was a leading painter who helped to create the Impressionist style. He painted portraits and still life, and above all, he painted social scenes of the day. Around 1892, Renoir developed rheumatoid arthritis, which is a hard disease that makes it hard to move your hands and your joints, so it made it very hard for him to paint. So in 1907, he moved to the warmer climates, a farm off the Mediterranean coast. He painted during the last 20 years of his life, even though the arthritis severely limited his movement, and he was even wheelchair bound. He developed progressive deformities in his hands and his right shoulder, requiring him to adopt his painting technique. It has often been reported that in his advanced stages of arthritis, he painted by having a paintbrush strapped to his fingers. But this is just horrible. But it's amazing because Renoir remained able to grasp a brush, although he required an assistant to place in his hand. The wrapping of his hands with bandages, apparent in his late photographs of his life, showed that he even did that to prevent skin irritation. Now, during this period, he also created sculptures by having a younger artist, Richard Guano, work the clay, but he would tell him what to do. Renoir also used moving canvases on a picture roll to help him paint large works. Now, he did all this with great perseverance, and he did it throughout pain because he just loved making art. In the late 1860s, through the practice of painting light and water in the open air, he and his friend Claude Monet discovered that the color of shadows is not brown or black, but the reflected color of the objects surrounding them, an effect today known as diffuse reflection. Several pairings of paintings exist in which Renoir and Monet are working side by side, depicting the same scenes. Renoir experienced his initial acclaim when six of his paintings were first introduced at the Impressionist exhibit in 1874.
Wow, look at that.
What's the big deal? Some lady rowing a boat.
You think it's that easy?
I don't know.
You gotta be strong to row a boat like that.
I guess you're right.
I bet when she was a little girl, she did a lot of exercises. And I bet she ate a lot of healthy foods. Like fruits and vegetables and tofu.
Tofu? Ew.
Yeah, tofu's good for you. You ever tried it?
Well, no.
Then what do you know?
Well, did she play basketball?
Of course she did.
Man, she can move. I kind of like this painting.
I told ya. Come on, let's get something to eat.
Okay. Maybe some tofu.
Okay.
Now, here is our Renoir perspective art project. And here is a normal Renoir painting. Of course, there's movement. That has a nice winding path going along the river. Has nice perspective that shows the river and path going way off into the distance. And we see some fun details like someone working on the tree, some people sitting along the shoreline, a gentleman walking way down the path off to the river, just join the other people who are sitting along the beach or the shore. It's a very fun scene. We're going to make a scene similar to this, except there will be no river. We're going to make a field of flowers, but this also shows perspectives. So let's look at another piece of artwork that is more of a field. Oh, what just happened? Did that guy just fall over? I think that guy just fell over. Oh my goodness. Oh, no one's even going over to him. What in the world? All right, so anyway, here's the other field I was talking about. It's a flower field. And you can see how the path gets way off into the distance, making you want to go on that long journey. Now here's the painting we're going to make today. Notice that the flowers in the front are big, colorful dots, and the ones that are in the back are really small, colorful dots. Notice the path starts out wide up front, and it gets really small in the back. That is how you show perspective. I'll make things look far away and up close. All right, have fun.